So let's start. So this is 25 February shipped to paper. Yes. And in the last class, we have solved some questions. Now let's continue the next question. So see here, what is this question? In a traveling wave, the particle at x is equal to 0 is undergoing SHM given by y of t is equal to a sine omega t plus phi naught. This particle is at y is equal to plus a by 2. That is what? Displacement, and a is amplitude a by 2, and is moving towards negative y direction. Find the phi naught. Okay? This is what the question is. Now see here. First, y displacement is given. That is a sine omega t plus phi naught. Okay? Right. Now, if t is equal to 0, if t is equal to 0, what we are getting? This is what displacement that is equal to a by 2 is equal to a sine. This is t is equal to 0. So this is only phi naught. So this and this a will get cancelled. So what we are getting? Sine phi naught is equal to 1 by 2. Now for what values we are having this 1 by 2 value of phi naught? See here. So phi naught may be, first of all, pi by 6. Enough. That is 30 degree. Next value is 5 pi by 6. Next value is 13 pi by 6. Next value is 17 pi by 6. Okay. So if you will see the oscillation of this particle here, suppose this is a mean position, we can say. And see here, this is 0. And this is extreme position, EP I am keeping, EP. Here also EP, and this is what? Mean position. And this is middle. So this is A by 2. This is what? A. Here down it is minus A by 2. And this is what? Minus A. So if we will take the condition, that is a by 2, how much it has traveled, we can say, because particle is moving like this towards the negative y-axis. So what should be the answer? Your answer should be what? This 5 pi by 6. Understood? Okay. So note down. So let's go to the next question. This is the next question. That is, a message signal of frequency FM is amplitude modulated and sent through a carrier signal of frequency FC. Find the wavelength of the signal if C is the speed of the light. So what we have to find here, we have to find wavelength of the signal, that is lambda we have to find. So this is what type of signal? Amplitude modulation. This is what? Amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulated signal I am writing. As this is amplitude modulated signal, we are just changing the amplitude, not the wavelength. So what happens here? Wavelength of signal modulated signal I am writing. remains same as carrier's signal. As carrier signal. So V is equal to F lambda, general formula we know. Here it is C is equal to FC into lambda. And now we want lambda. So therefore, lambda is equal to C by FC. This is what wavelength of this carrier wave we can say. So which option you will get? Option number A, C by FC. Okay. This V is what? This V is equal to F lambda is general formula. Okay. General formula. Okay. So note down. Okay. So let's go to the next question. And this is the question. There are, this is statement one and statement two. There are equal degrees of freedom for translational and rotational motion in a diatomic ideal gas. So what he is saying, equal degrees of freedom for translational and rotational motion in a diatomic ideal gas. Rotational motion of diatomic molecules follows Maxwell distribution. So this is what statement two, and options are like this. Statement one is true. Statement two is true. Statement two is the correct explanation of statement one. Statement one is true. Statement two is true. Statement one is false. Statement two is also false. And statement one is true. Statement two is true. But statement two is not the correct explanation of statement A. Okay. So, pehle, for diatomic gas, what is the reality? Let's see. For diatomic gas, how many degrees of freedom we are having? 5 degrees of freedom. DOF means degrees of freedom. So, how many degrees of freedom we are having if at low temperature we are, means this is a case when we are considering low temperature, means we are not considering vibrational degrees of freedom, only rotational and translation. So, out of this 5 also, if you have seen the notebook, see, you are having 3 translationals, and 3 translational and 2 rotational. Three translation and 2 rotational. And rotational motion does not follow the Maxwell distribution law. So rotational motion of diatomic gas does not follow Maxwell distribution. Maxwell's distribution. Okay. So see, 3 translational, 2 rotational, and obviously, you see, there are equal degrees of freedom, he is saying. Definitely, it is not, because there is 3 translational and 2 rotational. So, this is not true. And next to Maxwell's distribution, it is not obeying. So, obviously, what is your option? Both statements are false, and that is your option C. Understood? Note down, please. So, let's go to the next question. And see here, this is the next question. For a thermodynamic process, PV power 1 by 2 is equal to constant. Find T1 by T2 is equal to how much? They have given graph also. You can see here. V1, V1 by 2. This is T1 and T2. Pressure P1 and P2. On the x-axis volume, on the y-axis P. That is PV curve. Okay, now how to solve this? Now, what is given here? You see, the given is PV power 1 by 2 is equal to constant. PV power 1 by 2 is constant. Now see this side, we know PV is equal to nRT. This is what ideal gas equation. So from this, can I find out P value? What is that? nRT divided by P. nRT divided by P. So let's substitute here. So what you will get then? nRT divided by V into V power 1 by 2 is equal to constant. Okay. Right? Okay. Now, what is the relation between T and V now? So first of all, what I am doing, this V I will take it up. So nR, this is T, into this is V power minus 1, V power 1 by 2 is equal to constant. Now V minus 1 and V power 1 by 2 means how much, Ray? nRT into V power minus 1 by 2 is equal to constant. Right? Okay. Now after this, what I am doing, see, nRT divided by V power 1 by 2. Because this is minus at numerator, now I am taking again at denominator. So this is V power 1 by 2 should be constant. And therefore, nRT is equal to constant into V power 1 by 2. Take it. nRT is equal to constant into V power 1 by 2. Now, as this nR is also constant, and this is again a constant, so shall I say directly T is directly proportional to V power 1 by 2? Okay. Right? So let's find out now. Therefore, T1 by T2 is equal to V1 power 1 by 2 divided by V2 power 1 by 2. So I am writing here combinedly 1 by 2. V1 is what here? V1 is what? V1 is, bolo, kitna aayega V1? V1 is how much? 2 times V1, hai na? Or V2 is equal to V1 by 2. Hai ki nahi? Kyunki jab temperature increase hota hai, graph mein dekho, when temperature increases, your volume decreases. So that's why V1 I am taking as a V1 only, and V2 is nothing but V1 by 2 and whole power 1 by 2. So how much you are getting here? See now. Therefore, T1 by T2 is equal to 2 V1 by V1 whole power 1 by 2. This V1, V1 will get cancelled. So you are getting root 2 is to 1. Okay. So what is the answer? Option number C, root 2 is to 1. This is what? T1 by T2 ratio. Understood? Yes? Note down. Okay. So let's go to the next question. You see this question? X-ray photon of wavelength 10 angstrom. Okay. X-ray photon of wavelength 10 angstrom and a particle of mass x by 3 have same energy. Find x. And where h is what? Planck's constant. And use e is equal to mc square formula, he is asking. Okay, now first of all, you see we have two energy formulas, E is equal to H nu and also E is equal to mc square. So from these two equations, what we can say or what we can do? H nu is equal to mc square. Now this nu is equal to what, Ray? C by lambda, hai na? Because C is equal to nu lambda. Yes, no? C is equal to nu lambda. You know, P is equal to F lambda type, right? Same only. So here you see this C is equal to nu lambda, and therefore nu is equal to C by lambda. So therefore H C by lambda is equal to M C square, and this C will get cancelled. So now M is equal to how much, Ray? X by 3. So therefore H by lambda is equal to X by 3 into C. So what we have to find? X we have to find. So X is equal to three h by lambda c. Substitute the values, because in option h is as it is, so substitute h as it is. Lambda is 10 angstrom, means 10 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter, into c is 3 into 10 to the power 8. So how much you will get? This 3 will get cancelled with this 3, and this 8 will get cancelled with this. So how much here it is? Minus 2 are 10 power minus 2. So how much here it is? H divided by 10 into 10 to the power minus 2. Right? So this is nothing but this, again minus 2 will get cancelled with this 1. So how much you are getting? H by 10 power minus 1. And if this minus 1 is coming up, what is the value? 10H. And therefore X is equal to how much? 10H. Is that clear? Understood? Please note down. Okay, so let's stop here for today. Bye.